Hi, welcome to Final Facts Friday. This is a response video to a video that Kate BTPS did on her channel. She had one of these notebooks similar to this with fancy paper in, and she was taking it apart to use in her A5 Moleskine. These are A5 notebooks, half letter size if you're not UK. And the way she did it was a little bit convoluted. And I said to her, you know, there's a much easier way of doing that. And she said, oh, make a video. So here I am making a video. I'm actually going to show you three different ways of taking these apart, because if you're careful, you can actually use them for something other than your file facts as well. But the basic method I'm going to show you with this. Now, this is just a glued book. You can see there's no signatures in that book at all. It's just a wad of paper that's been put together and glued all the way down the back, and then a cover shoved on the front. Okay, as opposed to this blue one, which very clearly has signatures. And that means that it's got thread in it. It's a bound book. Now, you can also see, I think, that there is glue there as well. So the blue book is exactly like the book that Kate was using. Come back into focus, there we go. Now, to do this, you're going to need your notebook. You're going to need a ruler. Now, you need a ruler that is either a metal ruler or, like this one, has actually got a metal edge on it. This is a quilting ruler and they have metal edges so that you can score fabric, but I use it for cutting stuff. And you'll also need a craft knife or box cutter. Now, I prefer to use a big box cutter like this. It's a bit more heavyweight, heavy duty than the craft knives, and it's much easier to hold, it's much easier to handle, and it's much easier to cut through a thick wad of paper with it. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to find somewhere in the middle-ish, or somewhere at the beginning, I'm just going to find where I can tear off the cover, okay? So you can see there the cover's coming off and it's stuck with glue. Now, the reason I've taken a few pages is because this page is actually stuck to the cover. You can see there, it's stuck to the cover. And then this page is stuck to that page. So it's always best to come in a few pages, and then you break the spine of the book. So there's the spine of the book, break that. And once you pull it apart a little way there, you can then get your knife inside it. I only use a very short blade for this bit, and just run it down the glue. You're not trying to be too careful with this, you're just trying to get the back cover off, that's all. And it's a lot easier if you cut it. I need a little bit more. It's a bit deeper than I thought it was. See, it's quite easy to take it apart. There we go. I've actually cut through the back, but it doesn't matter. Because you can simply turn it over and do exactly the same from the other side. And this should be much easier because it's already unglued. So for instance here, there you go, a little bit of a pull and off it comes. Now, I'm not going to throw these away. I'm going to keep these because A5 Filofaxes are true to size. And this cover, because of the extra little bit around the back, is actually the same size as the A5 paper. So I'm going to keep this and turn it into a little divider for my A5 Filofax. All it needs is a little tab putting on it, and job done. And you've got two different dividers there. So they just need cleaning up, all this taking off it, trim off the edges, and you've got two plastic dividers, because this is a plastic notebook. And this notebook cost me 50 pence in Wilkinson's in the UK. So I would imagine you're looking at somewhere like Target in the US, or maybe even Walmart, somewhere like that, one of the grocery stores in the back to school aisle. The reason I'm using this particular notepad is because I love the paper. It's just so smooth. And Instead of being college ruled, it's not quite college ruled and it's not quite narrow ruled. It's kind of in the middle, which is, it's not ideal for me because I've got really tiny writing. I prefer the college ruled, but it will do. And it certainly saves me having to spend lots of money on refills. So the next thing you've got to do, it's very, very simple. All you're going to do is line your ruler up with the metal edge, get your craft knife or Stanley knife. Like I say, it's much easier with a Stanley knife because you've got a nice thick blade. And I'm using a self-healing cutting mat. This is one of the Jacquard cutting mats. And I'm going to stand up for this because it's always easier to do this standing up for me. Put your ruler down, and very carefully, and you don't need to put any pressure on, even if you've got problems with your hands, you don't have to have difficulties with this. Just nice and careful, keep your fingers away from the blade, obviously. I shouldn't have to tell you that, but you know, there might be kids watching, I suppose. And just keep slicing against the ruler. It may slip. It's very, very hot here today and it's slipping slightly because my hands are sweaty. Once you get down sort of halfway, you don't really need the ruler anymore, but I use it as a guide just to protect my fingers. Keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going. There you go, and what you've now done is sliced off all the paper, but unlike, sorry Kate, sounds rude, but I don't mean it like that. Unlike where Kate was saying, oh, you can, you know, you can accidentally cut it too small or cut the paper or it end up with a wibbly edge or whatever, this is a little bit, it's not quite straight. That corner went a bit awry because it got stuck on something. But basically all I've done is cut off the sticky bit. And what that means is that this paper now, instead of now having to again go through it all and let me just grab a piece of paper here. Instead of now having to go through it and, what's going on here? You know, tighten it up and shaving bits off. And she did say, you know, if you have to tidy it up, you're going to lose bits off the edge of your paper. This paper now, it's a loose stack of paper for a start. So all you've got to do is punch holes in it. But this paper is now almost exactly the same size as your standard A5 paper that you put in your Vilofax. It's almost exact. You've lost maybe, ooh, 2 millimetres, maybe, exactly 2 millimetres. You've lost 2 millimetres off the size of an A5 piece of paper by simply chopping off this. All this glue is just gone. So that's one way of doing it. So I can now use this for my Vilofax, which I desperately needed. If you've got a personal size one, then your book is going to be a little bit too big. So instead of just going straight ahead and taking off the covers and cutting off the back, what I do is take off the covers, so you're left with just this. So it's a block as a book. Measure it either from the bottom or the top, depending on whether you want the big gap at the top or not. Some people don't like the big gap. I always chop it off and turn it upside down because I prefer the gap at the bottom. Measure your personal size by, here she is. I like to measure using my fly leaf, but for the sake of the video, so that you can see what's happening, I'm going to use one of these.
So before you take the book apart here, measure it here, a little bit out from the spine, obviously, because you're going to cut that off. Cut that first while the book is still together, and then you can either cut this off and then cut that off as well, or even easier, you can just move this over to this corner and simply chop the book there. Now what that gives you, shall I actually show you? Would that be, that would be easier, wouldn't it? So while your book is still together, pretend that's still there and it's a big chunky book. First off, measure the top or the bottom, whichever bit you want to do, which happens to be that line there. And while the book is still in one piece, chop it off, okay? And then while the book is still attached on this side, take your paper, ignore the flap, obviously, and now cut it down to the correct width. So rather than cutting off the glue, you're cutting off a portion of the book to give you personal size paper. And again, all you've got to do is stamp it and stick it in your Filofax. But what you're left with then is this, a big pile of paper in a book form stuck to there. And guess what? That's perfect for shopping lists. You can just chuck it in the car and you've always got an on-the-go shopping list that you can just pull out and tear a piece off, and you don't have to keep lugging your Filofax around the shop. Marvellous! Okay. Step the second. I hope it's obvious by now that with these sewn notebooks, it's possible to do exactly the same thing. Take the cover off, chop off the back. But something else you can do with these, I'm going to sit back down for this so I'm a bit steadier. If you find, I don't suggest using the very back one because again, usually that's stuck to the flyleaf paper. So come in one and find the next signature. So there is the next signature. You can see the stitching here. There's the stitching in the middle, and that piece of paper goes right the way across the side of the book. So that's the next signature. And then you find where it meets the following signature. So somewhere here, in between the two, and sometimes it's only a couple of pages and sometimes it's not. So that's all one piece. And that's all one piece. There we go, there it is. And that's kind of stuck. Now, if you break the spine of the book again, you'll be able to see the stitching. There it is. See those little nodules there? That's the stitching. And all you need to do is cut through that stitching that's holding it together. And look, it all comes apart. Easy as pie. The good thing about doing it this way is that you get whole signatures together. And you can put two or three or four of those inside each other. Trim off the ends so that they are nice and straight at the ends. And then you can use those for your Midori notebooks if you want to, by simply, you know, perhaps adding a cover if you want to, maybe adding a bit of pamphlet stitch if the stitching has come apart on the individual signatures. But you can literally put two together inside each other, trim them up and add them to your Midori notebook. And, you know, this notebook cost me 80 pence in Wilkinson's. It's one of their basic artists range, student range of A5 notebooks, sketchbooks, and it's really lovely paper.
It doesn't bleed, it doesn't ghost, it doesn't, yeah, it even takes watercolour. It's fabulous paper. But this book's been hanging around a while and I need some paper in my Midori. So, yeah, I'm just going to pull some of this apart and turn it into little customised notebooks. And of course, alternatively, what you can do is simply take the outer cover off this, just like we did with the other one, and slice through the back, thereby taking off the stitching and the glue. And instead of losing 2 millimetres, you'll maybe lose 3. But again, A5 paper straight into your Filofax, this time plain paper. And yet again, you can cut it down to the height of the personal paper and then cut off the width of the personal paper, and you're left with a notebook that looks like that. And these plain notebooks are great for kids, because they're nice and small. Just chop it in half and you've got a nice tiny little notebook to stick in your handbag or your purse, or, you know, give to the kids, whatever. Nice tiny little notebooks. Because it's very hard to get tiny little notebooks like that are this thick. So, that's your alternatives. Lots of different ways you can use this, as I say. And even if you have plain paper — it doesn't work so well with lined paper because the lines are going the wrong way — but if you have plain paper, you can cut it in half again, or fold it in half again, and use it in your pocket notebook, because that is A6. Half of A5 is A6. That's how it works. A4, fold in half, get A5. A5, fold in half, get A6. And guess what? A6, fold in half, you get A7, which is the size for a mini. It's only the personal size that is an odd size. So there you go. All you need is a hole punch, and off you go. Have fun.